Hi, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Amos Leyers, I am a 3D environment artist, and in this tutorial we will go over on how to publish your asset or your game model on the Unity 3D Asset Store. So, first of all, what you want to do is you want to open a new Unity project, like this. Then, what we first want to do is you want to turn off DX11, so DirectX 11, because some Unity versions have some bugs in it that you can't open the asset store with it on. So if you can open the asset store, then everything's fine, but if not, you can go to File, Build Settings, then press Player Settings, and then just uncheck DX11 and press Apply. So now it's turned off. So I will go over on how to get a proper folder set up, so you won't have any problems with Unity saying that it isn't organized or anything, and I will then go over on how to actually publish your asset to the asset store. So for the folder setup, most of the time what I like to do to not get any problems is in the assets folder make another folder and call it the way you your package is called. So I'm going to just pick a barrel, for example, so like barrel pack, something like this. And in here I want to make a few folders. One folder for the scenes. Another one for the textures. Then another one for the assets. Another one for the prefabs. And that's about it for now. You can add other things like scripts or anything like that, but this is the basic folder setup. So now you have these folders. What you want to do is, first of all, we want to import our model. So I have this barrel over here. I can just click and drag it into Unity, and here's my barrel. Let's set the scale to 0.1 since I made it in Maya, so everything is in centimeters, and just leave it like that. Press apply. And now I will also import my textures. I will just import the diffuse, normal and speckler map for now. If you want to have other maps, for example for physics based rendering, then you can make your own shader for it, or you can just tell people on the S-Store that you have extra textures in it. But the Unity default shaders do not support physics based rendering just yet. This will be supported in Unity 5, which will probably come out this year. Okay, so now let's just drag these textures into the texture folder. Now what we want to do is we want to set up our scene. So drag and drop the barrel in here. The prefabs always need to be on position 000. So if you only have one model, you can do that right away, like this. So now it's on 000. It also needs to have the same scale as a human. So what I like to do is I will just go to assets, import package, and just import the character controller, just as a scale reference. So like this. And let's set that one to 0002. Now you can see that the barrel is way too small, so we can just go back to the FBX of the barrel, set it to 0.5, something like that, or you can scale it up manually. Let's keep it on 000, just as a scale reference. So let's say 0.4. barrels can have a lot of different sizes, so that doesn't matter too much. Now I can just delete the character controller. So basically what you want to do is, right now you want to first of all assign the textures to it. So let's pick a bumped diffuse, and let's just try and drop it in. Press fix now if you haven't assigned the normal map again. So if you want, you can also add a light to see your model to see your model better. Like this. So here's your model. Of course, I'm not going to spend too much time to make it look good. You can do that the way you want. So for the hierarchy, what you want to do is you want to create an empty game object. Call it assets or props. And in there you want to leave all your models. So for example, if you are making an entire environment, you just want to throw them in there. So now you've done that, what you want to do is we want to make a prefab of our barrel. So you can do this very simply. Click the prefabs folder and just click and drag the barrel in there. And here is our prefab. That's it. So for example, if you have a lot of different models and we have not made any prefabs for them yet. So for example, you have a model that is all the way over here, not at 000. What you can do is you can make a prefab of that folder. And then in the scene, select it, go to game object and break prefab instance. Now it's not a prefab anymore, but you still have the prefab. And in here you can just set the prefab to 000. And now if you drag and drop it in, you will see that it is on 000. So that's a nice little trick. So once you have set up your scene and your barrel and everything, now you can just save the scene, barrel pack scenes, and just call it demo or just call it scene. Here we go. So now I've done this, basically if you are making an entire environment, you of course want to use image effects or things like that. Then you just need to also drag and drop the standard assets into the barrel pack. Just make sure that everything is in this folder, because at the end Unity will upload only that folder. So everything out of it, that won't be uploaded. Also, don't place anything on the root of the folder. Always place it in subfolders, because sometimes the uploading can miss some files if you do that. So what you want to do now is you want to download the Asset Store tools. So go to Windows and Asset Store. Oops, it's a bit big. Once it loaded, I can just scale it down. Looks like I can't really scale it down. Well, anyway, if you are on the front page, what you want to do is you want to go all the way down. So because of my recording, the screen is too big. So all the way down, you will find a publish your asset link. You can click that, or you can type in the search bar asset store tools. And that would also bring you to it. So basically you need to download this pack. It is made by Unity and this will allow you to upload your packs to the Unity Asset Store. So just press import and import it. It will be very fast. So now you have your Asset Store tools folder and your barrel pack. So if you click on the top bulk, you will see a Asset Store tools. And if you then go to package manager, most of the time it will ask you to log in with your Asset Store account. If you do not have an account yet, you will need to make one. So basically you will get this window. So what you want to do is you want to click on package and then on create new. It's just below my screen. So now you can just not see it, but there will be a create new button. And if you click that, you will get this package. So let's start. So the package title will be a title of your package. So in our case it's barrel pack. Make sure to first look on the Asset Store if the title has not been used yet, because else Unity will just send it back and say that you need to change the title. In the description, it's smart to give a quick summary of what it is. So for example, some low poly game ready barrels or something like that. And then also give some info with, for example, the prefabs. So let's make an info dot point, and then give your open bracket, br open bracket. Basically, this will mean an enter, so a space, and then let's go one down, also a br, and under there, let's say, for example, prefabs, and then type in one in this case, textures, type in one, because it has, well, actually you can set it better to materials, because you have one material. So now once you have done that, you want to go down and you want to also say what kind of textures you have. So for example, just set br to get two spaces, and then texture types, something like that. It doesn't really matter what you want, just get the info in there and make it look professional. So texture types, and then type in diffuse dot br normal map br and specular map. Don't use any shortcuts for the words, because they don't like that. So here I also forgot to set some BRs. So you get the point. You can make a big summary if you want, just get everything ready into place. So once you've done that, what you want to do is you want to go to category and type in or select where you have the category. So for us it's 3D models, props, and then in this case exterior, or actually let's pick industrial, and then you can set the price. You can set it for free, or you can go all the way down to about 1k. And if you have a prop that is worth more, then you need to contact Unity and ask them if you can sell it for more. So let's now just make the package free. For the asset folder, let's pick the barrel pack, select. And then for the main files, you can just select some prefabs, like 3 or 4. If you have a big environment, just select like 10, maybe 5 to 10 of your main assets, and press done. So now you have these key images. For the key images, what you want to do is you want to open up internet. Or actually what you can do is you can go at the top here, s.tools, and then key image templates. And this will open up the internet for you, and it will download the key image template. So in here you will find a PSD or a PNG file. So I like to always pick the PSD. And in here you have the big, the icon, and the small. So if you would open this in Photoshop like this, then you will get these images. So basically what you want to do is you want to make a nice screenshot of your model or your environment, and then place them up here, and the images will say what you need to do. So you need to place your art here. So if you would pick a screenshot, you can like place it over here, and once it's done, uncheck the hide these layers and check the gradient mask, because in here will be the text of the asset store that you typed. And then here you will see your image. So you can do the same for this one and for this one. So just hide where it says hide, and just place your art above the your art here layer. So that's it. It's very explanatory. So of course I'm not going to make any now, because I'm not actually going to publish this. But anyway, in the key images you can add the icon, the small, and the big. Just save them as a JPEG file or a PNG file. And you can also add screenshots. So I would make some very nice screenshots. And in Photoshop maybe adjust them a little bit to make them really look like commercial screenshots. Like adjust the layers, maybe a bit of the lighting. Not too much, because of course people want to see the final product. So don't make it too different than the final product, because then, well, that's just not fair against the against your buyers. So once you've done that, you can click preview if you want. Of course, my screen is too big, but in here it will show your how it will look in the asset store, your final package. So some low poly game ready, and then prefabs, materials. As you can see, I mistyped a BI. So here you can check your text. Of course, I do not have any screenshots yet, but you get the point. So then you have done that. And then what you can do is you can press submit. And basically, because I don't have any images or any key images, I can submit it. But basically, if you press submit, you get a little window saying the version, and in there you just type in, for example, version 0.1 or version 1 or whatever you want, and you can give some additional info for the reviewer. For example, what I like to do is I like to say that all my prefabs are on 000 and that all the models have their own collider and their own material, things like that. So basically, maybe I can open up one of my environments that I am publishing now. So for example, this environment I am publishing, this environment is not on the S store yet because it is under review. So basically in here I have my title, I have a lot of info, and down here I have the category, the price. Of course, the folder is not in this project, so it will be red. And I have all my screenshots. So if I press preview now and let it load up, then you can see that over here I have my nice screenshots in there. I have my info in there. I can scroll down. It's also good to sometimes add, for example, a video or a web player to it. So basically you can scroll down, you can click on the screenshots and then you can see them. So things like that. So that's basically the point. So then it will, once you press submit, it will start uploading. And once it uploading is done, it will give you a message saying that the uploading is done. And then you will also get an email message saying that your package is submitted to the S store and will be under review. So most of the time the review takes, well, it depends. For a single model it will take very fast, like 1 or 2 days, but for a entire environment like this it can take about 3 to 4 days, not including the weekends. So that's about it for this tutorial. My name is Amos Legers and thank you for watching 3dmotive.com.